a very early and easy indication that you could have for just about anybody is to say, okay, well, when I talk to you about change, do you see that as something that is negative or has a negative connotation? Or what if I was to say the word opportunity alongside change?
The question is from Thinking Focus.
So the question is, why do some people think that if they ignore change, it will go away? Hello, I'm Richard from Thinking Focus.
Hello, I'm Rob from Thinking Focus.
The question is from Thinking Focus, a podcast about how we sometimes get in our own way and what we can do about it.
I think it's because it's a comforting way of thinking about it. It's far more comfortable to just ignore stuff.
To pretend it's not really happening.
Yeah. It's, you know, ostrich head in the sand.
Yeah.
Absolute classic for that. It's not real. It's just a rumour. There's some stuff that they might have heard on the grapevine or other people are talking about, which they don't really get or understand.
Yeah.
You know, the other people don't get or understand.
Yeah.
They're just building.
It'll never happen.
Exactly.
Saying those sorts of things.
Yeah, all of that. It's, you know, you're in denial, really, about the fact that actually some stuff might be happening in the organisation, which you are not part of, which you never saw coming. And because you can't make meaning or sort of find any meaning in it, far easier to ignore it.
So we see this in organisations because people perhaps don't understand enough.
Yes.
Or because they don't want to understand. Is it maybe often because it's not been explained properly to them?
Well, I was going to say, when you gave that description, it's about maybe not even having the information in the first place. So there's this whole thing about, am I aware of what's going on anyway? Have I been given any information? If I have been given some information, what does that information mean? How does it affect me? And typically, an attitude, and I know that that's a generalisation, an attitude towards changes, it's going to hurt, I don't like it. So it's more comforting to ignore it.
So if I were to, or we were to find ourselves in this situation, and people listening to our podcast might have been in this situation, or in it, or about to be in it, what could you do to help yourself then if you recognise that this could be happening to you?
I think information, you come back to information again, you have to go and find out actually what is going on, and get some sort of, understanding around what the current situation is.
So try and get some certainty.
Yeah.
And also, is it fair to say then that one of the things I need to do is try and separate what's fact from fiction?
Yes.
Because you were mentioning the rumour mill and all those sorts of things. So I could pay quite a lot of attention to stuff that I suppose seems plausible, but actually there might not be any evidence to back it up.
Well, and think about what typically is happening. In lack of information, some other people, maybe including yourself, are filling that information in. You know, you're taking the gaps.
Yeah, so there's a void.
There's a void, and you're filling that void. Because precisely because you're talking about certainty and wanting to know and get some clarity about some things, anything that is missing in the story that you're telling yourself, you go, oh, it must be because, oh, and that's why. So you're searching or looking for meaning where meaning might not actually be there.
So psychologically then, I guess there, because I haven't got certainty, something is said, there's a rumour or something about something that's going on.
Mm-hmm.
What I have to do is I have to use the information I already have in my brain, maybe from when I've been through something like this before, or I've seen something like this before, or I know someone that's been through something like this before, and I use that map of the world that I've created from a previous experience to try and fit it into this one.
Absolutely. And look at that two ways. Just imagine if those things that you've just described have always been bad before.
Yeah.
What if my map of the world is, whenever I've been faced with change before, it's always left me with a poorer situation.
Therefore, equals bad.
Absolutely. So it's like, so as soon as somebody mentions, oh, a new change, you go, oh, hang on a second, it's always been bad before, so it's likely to be bad again this time around. Because that's, you know, that's your experience. That's what your experience tells you.
So what we're saying there is if this is happening to you, then it's about separating fact from fiction, and it's about going and looking for some certainty.
Yes.
So therefore, are we saying there's some choices that you've got to make there about where you want to spend your energy and your time?
Well, I think so. I mean, there's the initial choice is to actually go looking for information in the first place, couldn't you? Because you could just sit ignoring this to the extreme that you have an expectation that people will come and find you, people will come and look after you.
Yeah.
So you do have to make a choice to go, I need to go and find out what that information is. I need to demystify this. I need to get some greater clarification. What is actually going on? So yes, there's a choice there to go and
to be
find
proactive
out.
Rather than to sit and wait it and be reactive.
Absolutely.
So let's move that on slightly then. What if I am leading others or managing others, or maybe I'm just at a peer level with others, but I can act as a leader within that peer group? How might I help others that I recognise are, you know, ignoring that this change is actually happening?
So I think part of that is to have an expectation in the first place that this is normal human behaviour, that there will be a proportion of people, maybe quite a high proportion, who would choose to, you know, act in this way to begin with. Yeah, I'm ignoring this. I want it to go away. I'm not comfortable with it.
Yeah.
So if you have that expectation as a leader of other people or as a helper of other people in an organization, then you're looking for those clues. But you're also, you can guess at what the psyche of an individual might be and what's going on in their mind. So you could ask some very easy and fundamental questions about, so what are you thinking about at the moment? What's bothering you at the moment? Because it's a fair guess that actually they're not comfortable with some stuff that's going on.
Yeah.
The other thing is, as a leader, is to think about, so what information would I like in that situation? What information should I give?
Put yourself in their shoes
and
think about, okay, so what might be going through their mind here? And therefore, what information could we give that we haven't given?
Absolutely.
Or do we need to give again?
Yes.
To help provide some certainty.
And there's a bit about that as well, around what information can we give and should we give, as opposed to what information might we have to give at another time?
So is it fair to say that in this then, we're looking for, if you're leading others, you're looking for someone to have a bit of a mindset shift or change,
right,
where actually you've gone from seeing the changes being, ignoring the change, to perhaps the change being a threat, through to, okay, what's the opportunity here for me then within this?
Yeah. I mean, there's a very early and easy indication that you could have for just about anybody is to say, okay, well, when I talk to you about change, do you see that as something that is negative or has a negative connotation? Or what if I was to say the word opportunity alongside change? Do you see change as an opportunity, or do you see change as something that is going to adversely affect you?
Is it easy for people to see change as an opportunity if there's a fair bit of uncertainty still around? Because you're not going to necessarily have loads of certainty, are you, from the start, that you know the answers to everything and how it will affect you and what's going to happen?
Correct. But you can take that question stage further and go, what opportunities might there be as a result of this change? Have you thought about that? Just to stop somebody from thinking that everything's going to be bad or everything's negative in relation to this and go, oh, well, I wonder. There could be an opportunity because we don't know what's going to happen, do we? So to your point about uncertainty, then we can start asking some questions about, so what is it you'd like to be more certain about? What questions have you got going on in your mind? Because that will lead us to trying to think about the sort of information they might need. Because if you think about uncertainty in the purest sense of describing it, all that really means is you got some questions in your mind that you haven't got answers to.
Yeah, yeah.
So where are you going to get those answers? You know, can you find those answers yourself, or are you expecting those answers from somebody else? In my experience, typically you're looking for those answers from somebody else. If I'm thinking about as a leader, then I need to think about what are those questions?
If I can, do I know the answers?
Can I provide? Absolutely.
And how? Level of certainty.
And how often?
Yeah.
You know, and do I need to repeat them a few times? So all of those things are helpful to remove that uncertainty for people.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Rob. Really, really interesting. So there we've been talking about, why do some people feel that they ignore change, it'll go away.
Mm-hmm.
And we've talked quite a lot about a number of things, about choice.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit in there around, actually, it's completely natural.
Yes.
But also about certainty.
Yeah.
And particularly if you're leading people, trying to provide as much certainty as is possible.
Yeah.
So others can start to realise that change is happening and that we need to have that mindset shift and look at the opportunities that are available.
Okay. Even if it's just about diminishing the level of uncertainty.
Yes. Not completely getting rid of it.
Absolutely.
But diminishing it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Rob.
All right. No worries.
Next time on The Question Is...
If you stamp your feet and shout enough, you'll get what you want. And of course, the reality is that that's not really how it works. Most of us will reach a more rational viewpoint at some stage that's more considered and more thought through and more sensible when we start to make sense of things.
Thinking Focus works with teams and business units in organizations around the world, helping them achieve breakthroughs by enabling them to think differently. To find out more about our work and how we could help your organization, go to www.thinkingfocus.com.
Hi, this is Paul from Thinking Focus. I just wanted to let you know that this podcast is part of a series on the myths that often occur during times of organisational change. You can find other podcasts in the series and some special resources related to these myths at thinkingfocus.com/myths.